In today's video, I'm going to share with you how to use Procreate to create ombre eyebrows. Welcome to my channel. My name is Erica and I'm a professional permanent makeup artist. If you are here for the very first time, welcome. Our content is designed to help artists improve their permanent makeup work. If you are interested in permanent makeup, please consider subscribing to my channel. I put out new content every week. Procreate is an incredible app and I love it so much, especially for permanent makeup practice. You can easily draw and layer and create gradient anywhere. You don't have to worry about your paper smudging, and you can save them and have them on hand to showcase your clients and share your skills on social media. Let's get started. Open the app and familiarize yourself with layering. The bars on the right-hand side of the screen are the brush size bar and the opacity bar. When the opacity is at 100%, the brush is very bold and can create a harsh eyebrow design. Additionally, the brush size should not be too large as we want to work in a smaller area. On the top right-hand corner, there is the brush, the eraser, and the blending tool. You will learn to use all three in our video today. Let's start by first drawing an eyebrow design. As I'm drawing a straight line, I hold the pen down and it will straighten the line for me. I like to draw the eyebrow design with a bright color so that we can see the borders as we are layering. Keep in mind, when drawing your eyebrow design, beautiful eyebrows should always follow the eyebrow shaping rules. The bulb to the arch should be approximately 60% of the length, and the arch to the tail should be approximately 40% of the length. The tail should not go lower than the front of the head of the brow. Tail should go out, not down. Soft curvature to the front of the eyebrow and soft change in angle will result in a very desirable eyebrow shape. I then add layer number 2 and adjust the color to a nice brown with an orange base. Familiarize yourself with the brush choices. I'm going to let you in on a secret. In the brush library, many of the inking and sketching brushes can be used for powder pixelated effect. To try out a brush and see if you like the effect, tap the brush twice. This will open the stroke properties. Under the stroke properties, adjust the spacing and the jitter. You can try out what you've adjusted it to right on that screen. Let's go through the sketching brushes and see which are appropriate for creating a pixel effect. The Derwent brush is also super awesome for creating a pixel effect. The Procreate pencil is one of my favorites. It's so amazing and versatile, and you'll see I use it quite frequently. HB pencil is also a really nice candidate for creating a pixel effect. I like 6B pencil and the Narinder pencil. Now let's switch over to the inking brushes. I'm not such a fan of the Mercury brush for this purpose. The Inca brush and the Pandani brush, I'm also not sure that they are appropriate for this effect. I love the Tinderbox brush, but you can see if I leave the brush size too large, it's not really appropriate. But if you make it much smaller, you definitely could use it. the syrup brush also gives a really nice effect. Honestly, experimenting with all of these brushes, there are endless creations to creating soft powder brows or ombre brows, and the creativity is endless, leaving your social media images and drawings that you create for your clients endless. I don't feel the thylacine brush is appropriate to be used for this creation. Really like the technical pen as long as you take the brush size down significantly. The gel pen and the ink blade both can totally be used. Ink blade is one of my very favorite brushes. As you can see, I deleted a layer and I can turn off and turn on layers. So I'm going back to layer one and making it visible. I'm starting with the ink blade brush and working in sections, overlapping between each section, just as I would if I was working with a permanent makeup handpiece. I move forward with my second pass, darkening the darkest and dark portions of the bottom of the eyebrow. As you can see, I'm working with not 100% opacity to try to blend a gradient together. Now I'm going to switch to my Procreate pencil. As you can see, I tapped twice on the screen to delete something that I did not like. And I'm moving with the Procreate pencil, blending in a horizontal and vertical motion to create my darkest segment. I'm working in the dark and darkest segment where 2/3 of the bottom portion of the eyebrow from the tail up until the bulb, I'm leaving about a centimeter or so off of the front of the bulb. To secure the bottom outline, I lower my brush size and try to create that darkest segment. I'm going to blend a little bit to create this nice gradient and get rid of any patchiness. Now I'm going to switch to my peppermint brush and I'm going to darken the color a little bit, but the base is still orange. I'm working in the 1/3 section of the lowest part of the eyebrow. I like to work both horizontally, diagonally, and vertically. As you can see, my pinky is anchored, and I'm using my fingers to move my pen back and forth just as I would move my handpiece. I love Procreate so much because I can move my canvas around in the app by pinching and rotating my fingers, and this is so much easier than drawing on an actual pad. Again, and while I'm blending, a secret I've learned is to always lower down the opacity and the brush size because you don't want to blend harshly, you want it to blend really softly. Another layer and lighten the color some. I switched out to my Narrander pencil. I'm working diagonally and vertically to blend my darkest segment into the dark segment and to blend the overall gradient together. Now I'm using the eraser tool to clean up the edges. I tap on each layer, making it visible and invisible to see where I've shaded outside of my design. More density to my design, I'm going to use a charcoal pencil and adjust the color slightly. I'm adding into the darkest and dark segments with the charcoal. I blend the charcoal in with the other layers. I then add another layer with the Procreate pencil and lightening the color some, just to give a little more contrast to the design. If you use your pen to tap on the screen, it will tap pixels into the design. I then clean up the edge with my eraser tool and a Y brush. There you have it. There's my finished product. Now, as my creativity gets flowing, I honestly could continue working on this eyebrow for another 20 minutes or 40 minutes, but I think this is a really great stopping point. And if you wanted to share your Procreate creations with me or get any feedback, tag us on Instagram and I will share my critique with you. I totally hope this helps you in your permanent makeup journey. Thank you for watching. Please like, subscribe, and follow for more permanent makeup and beauty magic. For more details, visit the description box below. Bye!